Hello guys, it's Nidhvis and today it's going to be a very interesting topic. So basically, once you get some like 4 to 5 and 6 Beyblades, you obviously start mixing, matching the parts, and like then you come across a question that which part will be good with which part, and how would I understand that? So then you just go on the internet and there are many forums and all, even IBA shows it, and also there are many tournaments, and also you just blindly copy the data there, and like you are like, yes, this is combo, ye combo hai, and use karunga main. So that's like the point where you go wrong basically, because you just copy the combo and that's not enough. So the topic of today is how to build your own combo. So like, it's not necessary you have to be unique, but when you are even copying, for example, if you take a combo, say Spriggan Requiem, zero bump bearing, okay, and you are in left rotation, and your opponent is using Nightmare Longinus, which is in also left rotation. So if you blindly copy that Beyblade and you launch it at full speed, your Spriggan Requiem, and he also launches his Nightmare at full speed, you know what's going to happen. You will just burst. So that's like a lame thing to do, if you are understanding what I'm saying. So it's like a not a smart move there. So basically you need to understand how the combo which you are using works properly. So for that, when you start building your combo, or even when you copy a combo from internet, for example, say XYZ combo is trending, so you just copy the combo, and at that time try to learn what each disc, like what the disc, the layer, the driver and the frame does. So for example, if you take a combo which was very popular, which was Hell Salamander, and then you put 7 glaive, and then it was bearing. So this combo was a very standard combo and really awesome. So I had seen that combo. Then later on, what I did was I tuned the combo a little bit. I removed 7 and I put 5 in place of that. Now you would ask, why 5? So the reason for putting 5 was that 5 has more burst resistance compared to 7. Obviously, there was some decrease in stamina, but getting that more burst resistance meant like when you are facing a left rotation Beyblade, you won't burst suddenly. So that was a small example like how you can think and decide for a combo if it's good or bad, or what you can improve. So basically, I think you must have got my point. Now if you talk about the layers, let's say Nightmare Longinus, okay, you got your Nightmare Longinus and you have your Odax also. So you somewhere from someone, from me, if you can say, you got a bump frame also. Okay, so you take your Nightmare Longinus and you put your bump frame and your extreme driver, and there you have it. Voila, great attack type, awesome. But the problem is that you don't know to launch it. That's like a very serious problem there. If you don't know to launch it, even if your combo is really awesome, top notch, what's the use? So basically, for that, you need to practice, and for that, you need to analyze and be one with your combo. I know being one with your combo sounds so anime, but it's like reality. When you are using attack type Beyblade, you need to practice your angles, how you are launching, and how far you should be from the stadium, or where should you keep your hands, and where like what target you should aim in the stadium. Like if you launch too far away, your Beyblade would just hit the wall and lose its stamina. That would be like a wrong thing to do, right? It would be like waste of stamina. Then what you would attack with is which the Beyblade which is in the center, it would get hit less and there would be less chances of you winning. So pretty much I think you must have understood what I want to say. The thing is that what I'm suggesting is, do not exactly copy what you are seeing. Try to build your own combo, try to analyze, try to examine the discs which you have. For example, I said 5 has greater burst resistance, on the contrary 7 has awesome stamina, 4 also has good enough stamina but it's not awesome like 7, and so on and so forth. So there are many ups and downs and variations to compare. So instead of just copying, guys, if you try to focus on these things, it would be like really awesome to build combos and all. Like, it's really fun. Sometimes when I'm free, I almost take 1 hour and all to build combos and all. It's really awesome to plan and see, instead of just blindly copying a combo and taking it into a tournament saying, yeah, top tier combo hai mera, sabko hara dega, but at the end you only lose. So that's like a very funny thing to do. So basically, instead of that, just learn your combos, how you are using it, how you are pursuing it. So that's it for today, guys, and do check my community tab. I'm going to post something about the schedule of my videos from now on. So I have introduced Vanguard also, and there is a good response from people. So people do want Vanguard, but I obviously don't want to quit Beyblading also. So it's going to be both of them and also IBA videos. So like that, a schedule will be made. I don't know how much I will be able to follow, but surely I will try to follow. And that's it for today, guys. Stay tuned, take care, and bye bye.